Monday morning, it was all. Oh, hello. You're here. A little early. That's good. Monday morning. It's all I hoped it could be. We've had a special request to go around the shop and have a look at just the raw crystals that we've got. So we're going to do that. That's a great thing to do. And as we go, I will talk you through where the crystals come from and the properties of the crystals. How does that sound? Sound good? Well, come and join me then. Here we are again. This is the back crystal table. Let's have a look at the first one that catches my eye. This is blue lace agate. Can you see those lines? Beautiful. Look at those. That's one of the features of blue lace, and obviously that beautiful ethereal blue colour. It's lovely to see it in its raw form like this. There's a little bit of copper or iron going through the back of it there, giving it that very gentle gold colorization. Blue lace agate is known as the communication stone. It helps people who have difficulty being heard. We all feel like that at times, don't we? People who need confidence and articulation to share their truths. It provides clarity of thought and clarity of intent. It helps us to see what is really important. It helps us to put our priorities in order. It is one of the main stones of the diplomat, assisting communication in situations where anger must be avoided. It helps there to be understanding in the person that is close to this rock crystal. If you have this around you for a while, it's a big chunk this is, look how big that is in my hand. It will help you to be understanding of others and see other people's points of view, hence the stone of the diplomat. This stone also helps sore throats on a physical level, swollen glands, it helps to fight away infections. It also helps with the thyroid problem. You know, when you have thyroid problems, it helps with that. It supports the thyroid. So that's a great healing stone and a stone of understanding and communication. Blue lace agate. Beautiful. Nice raw piece there. Let's pop that back. There. And let's move along until we see another raw piece. There's the beautiful celestite that we spoke of last time. Lovely stone there, a lovely crystal. And what's this we've got coming up? That's like a crystal landscape, isn't it? We're sort of flying over that landscape. Okay, this is very interesting. Now, it's not polished on the front, it's just cut right through, which again is nice because you see how it is before it's being polished or sculpted into something. It's actually very, very matte. And this stone is snowflake obsidian. If I hold it that way, can you see the snowflakes? They literally look like little snowflakes going through the obsidian. Now, all of the obsidians are very, very protective. They protect us spiritually and energetically, and also protect us physically as well, keep us out of harm's way. Look at that beautiful colorization on the back there, where it's at its roughest. Wow, look at the snowflakes coming through. They look quite golden, actually, when you're not looking at a slice of it, but a more of a raw side of it. So you can see that familiar obsidian colorization there, very, very, very black. And also it kind of looks a bit like glass because it is, it's nature's glass. That's one of its characteristics there, with the light bouncing off it. You can see what I'm talking about there. It's like black glass. It's nature's black glass. A stone of purity. It brings about a balance to the body and the mind and the spirit. It helps to keep us centered and focused in very chaotic situations. That's a good stone for now, isn't it? For right now. It brings harmful thought patterns to the surface so that we can deal with them and then purge ourselves of them. It's a gentle stone compared to normal obsidian. It's just as strong in its protective qualities, but it's gentler how it actually delivers those properties, those qualities. And so as a result of that, it's good for all ages, including children. Normal obsidian, we've got some here. Oh, the big piece is gone, hasn't it? There we go. Normal obsidian, great for adults, but can be a little bit strong for children. We say always go for the snowflake, but it's not weak in its effect. It delivers what it needs to deliver. It just does it in a very sympathetic way. Snowflake, obsidian, raw piece. And we call that a slice. If I show you like this, it's just been cut straight through, not polished, cut straight through. You can see all those beautiful snowflakes there. A lovely protective stone for all ages. Let's pop that back. If you look at the little egg there, you can see how black this stone goes when it's polished. It's nice to see it raw though. That's just as it would be, taken out the grounds and then cut in half. No polishing there. And let's continue through our crystal landscape, flying above all these different crystals. This is very, very interesting actually. I'll quickly show you this because you hardly ever see this. This is a patchy tear. There's a patchy tear there, yeah. Now these aren't tumbled, this is how they form. Let me show you a typical Apache tear shape. You see how it looks like, I don't know whether you can make that out there, it looks like a piece of plasticine that's been pinched in two places with thumb and finger. That's its shape. It's not polished like that, not tumbled. That's how it actually grows. That's how it comes out of the ground. And the reason it gets that shape and takes on that shape is because you see this strata rock that's around this particular Apache tear. Can you see it coming out of the rock? Well, this rock is really, really soft. It feels quite chalky. You can feel maybe a small amount of it on your skin, only slightly, as you're touching it. And the actual crystal itself wouldn't take on that shape unless it was in this surrounding rock. You see, the reason it's rare to see it in its surrounding rock, and there's a few more there as well, can you see that one coming through there, is because the rock is so chalky and gentle that it totally erodes away, but not before it's produced the crystal. So it comes to the surface, the chalky rock starts to disappear, and it leaves that crystal inside. There's perfectly formed in that lovely Apache tear shape, like it's been pinched. It's nice to actually get it in its supportive shell, the very thing that creates its shape. Let me have a look and show you another piece here. Look at that coming through there. Apache tear. Again, very grounding, very protecting. Clears negative emotions, focuses on emotions more than anything, Apache tear. Excellent for healers. Excellent for people that have a heightened sense of awareness. Helps you to balance that ability that you have and use it in a healing way. when we're oversensitive, it can be a little bit destructive to ourselves, can't it? We need to be able to balance those sensitivities. Moving across, let's kind of like fly over here. Wow, there's the alestial that we had a look at in an earlier video. Look at all this amethyst. Beautiful pieces, massive pieces, some of these. If anybody likes the look of these, if I put my hand there, you get an idea of how big they are. They're big. Let's just pull it out. Big, big pieces. Beautiful dark purple. Look at that. We've had these pieces for a long time. They're something of showpieces, but they are for sale. Look at all those points coming through there. It's nice to see the raw rock on the back and the crystal coming out of that rock. Billions of years there of pressure and time and heat. These are crystal beds that we've got here. Look at the size of that one. It's just kind of like fly over that one. Lovely sparkling there through the darkness. This is interesting. Well, it's all interesting. This is particularly interesting. You see this amethyst here? Can you see the white going through it? I don't know whether you can make it out on the video, but the white going through it is actually quartz crystal growing on top of the amethyst. Now that's special, isn't it? Lovely to see that. A nice thick chunk. You can see all the strata rock underneath. Lovely green colours coming through there. You get the greens and the purples very often together in a geological sense. Look at that. Let's pull that back around the other way so you can see it. Look at all the quartz crystal growing through the channels of the amethyst. Look at that, it's a beauty. It's a heavy piece, that. Again, we've had this one for a while, but they are all for sale. Can you see that mark there? That's that's not a piece of debris on the top or black marker pen. That's actually about 3 or 4 millimeters inside the crystal, and I've actually not noticed that before. I'm going to have a closer look because I have a feeling it could be a little creature. Now that very often doesn't happen with crystal. It tends to happen with things like amber, because you imagine the resin, imagine like on a Jurassic plane, and the resin of the tree, the sap is running down the outside of the tree and it catches an insect and it just freezes that insect in time, and then the insect travels down through the eons. That happens quite a lot. But to actually have little things, and I will have to have a closer look, don't quote me on it, but from where I'm looking, they look like, those black dots there look like little creatures. We'll have to have a closer look at that. If they are little creatures, then they're billions of years old. That's how, that's how long it takes for these things to form. But yeah, look at that. A beautiful piece, nice and thick, with clear quartz growing on the top through the channels of the amethyst. Very special. Let's pop that piece back. Yeah, that's it. Lovely, lovely. Let's fly over our crystal landscape. There we go. I'll just quickly show you that. This is not a raw piece. This has been polished, but can you see that? Can you see that lovely floor right there? I've just popped an egg on top, but really this is for something like a crystal ball. So imagine having a base like that for your crystal ball. You know, fluorite's very lifting, and a crystal ball helps you to connect with spirit and the higher blessed levels. So the fluorite as a base as well, it really helps you to see things visually, helps you to see visions, helps you to be clairvoyant. So a crystal ball on top of a fluorite base like that, is that actually quite something? It doesn't quite do it justice with a little egg on top there, but it gives you the idea of what you can do with it. Okay. Let's get back to the raw pieces, getting off subject there. I just saw it at the corner of my eye. It's like, ooh, what's that there? It's lovely blues coming through at the bottom. We seem to have a spate on blue fluorite at the moment. It's brilliant. It's very rare. This is interesting. You never see black tourmaline in its raw form like this. Look at that. It's as thin as an 80 gram piece of paper. And what I'm referring to here is each one of the little levels there. Can you see it's almost built up like slate? And each level, each layer is as thin as a piece of paper, and it's all bound together. Look at that. Try and keep it in focus there for you. There we go. Let me show you what I was looking at earlier. Can you see all those levels, all those layers built up on top of each other like slate? This is a treat. It's black tourmaline, totally rough, as it would have come out of the ground. It's nice to see it like this. It's quite a thing with all its levels. It's got some nice surface patterns as well there. The familiar tourmaline patterns. Let's have a look on the back as well. There we go. Really thin layers all stacked up. And that sound, you might have been able to have heard that sound then as I turned it around in my hand. You can actually feel the layers like a lattice of paper all stacked on top of itself, but bound really strong. Nice as well on the back. Black tourmaline helps to prevent things like energetic and psychic attack. If you feel like someone's got it in for you, black tourmaline stops their energy from getting to you. It's a great one for protecting something this size, for protecting your whole house spiritually, and just promoting a very, very positive attitude to all the people in that space. Something like this, left in one place, kind of central to the house, will generate an energy field that will protect pretty much the whole house. Obviously depending on the size of your house. I'm kind of going on a sort of standard 3-4 bedroom house. Central, roughly central to the house, if you find a room that's roughly central, and place it there, leave it there, it will generate a real, and look at those channels going through there, look at those markings. It will create a really strong energy field that will protect the whole of your living space. That's good, isn't it? That's got to be good. Black tourmaline, raw. Fantastic. Let's pop that back if I can. There. Lovely. Oh, where's my camera going? It seems to have a mind of its own. Some lovely red jasper there. We don't have any red jasper that's raw. We do have some dragon's blood calcite, that's raw. Look, it looks wet, doesn't it? Like it's a sort of red ice. Dragon's blood calcite actually has dragon's blood resin in, which is where it gets its name from. Look at the colours. This is a very ancient stone. It's classed as one of the ancient stones of wisdom. The energies of dragon's blood motivate the person that's close to it. It releases anger and fear, especially if rooted in the past. Helps you to let go of the past. And with all the calcites, the energy field itself will do all this. But when you hold it, a very small amount of it will come away and go into your bodily system. It's classed as a very loose mineral. That's why you would never put dragon's blood calcite, or any other calcite for that matter, in water, because over time it would actually dissolve away. It dissolves in water, but the moisture of your hand will take very small amounts of the mineral into your body. It supports the nervous system, and this one helps you to let go of fear and anger, especially if it's rooted in the past. I feel really calm just holding that. And all these stones are very tactile, but especially the calcites, because you can feel afterwards. You can feel the calcite on your hand, and you know it's doing you a lot of good. Dragon's blood calcite, you've probably never seen that before. I know we hadn't until we got some in. I will stay on a calcite theme and just quickly show you. See, this is raw as well. Orange calcite. This is the stone for people that worry. It stops you from worrying, helps you to let go of repeating thought patterns that you know are doing you no good. And you hold the calcite, the energy itself will do a lot of good. But the actual touching it is where the magic is, because the mineral rubs off, you take it into your body, you feel calm almost straight away. But what we say is, if people are really anxious or really low and maybe even depressed, give it about a week, 2 weeks, and you'll start to feel the effect. And how would you use this? Well, every day, at least 20 minutes, hold it for 20 minutes. Maybe you're reading a book or watching the telly, and longer if you can, because you're not going to overdose on this. The more of this micro mineral you can get into your body, the better. And you just hold it to do it. Just hold it. It feels comforting, it's very tactile, and just kind of like move it around in your hand like I'm doing here. And if you did that for a few hours every day, it would speed up the effects. But you'll find yourself feeling very peaceful inside, peaceful in your mind, and then over time, that sense of peace then washes down into your emotional body and your physical body. Because a lot of our turmoil and upset, we generate in our mind first, don't we? And then our bodies respond to those upsets in the mind. So if you can calm the mind right down so that you're not worrying, then your body starts to calm down and you really experience a sense of inner peace. And that inner peace is there all the time, regardless of the situation that you might find yourself in. I love orange calcite. Again, none of these have been shaped like this. This is raw. It's exactly how it would have looked, pulling them straight out of the ground. Lovely, lovely big pieces those. Nice big pieces. Okay. Shall I pan? Oh, hang on. That's a raw piece there. That's some raw fluorite. Can you see the quartz going down the middle there, the white line? That's pretty special. And growing there on the bottom. This is really deep emerald green. And that's another raw fluorite there. Very, very deep. Look at that. Oh, it's heavy. It's heavy when you pick it up. Beautiful. If I hold that, you see how dark that is. It's so dark, it's almost black in the middle. Beautiful. And there's some blue coming through there. Lovely, lovely. Lovely pieces. Very heavy. The blue really shows up there nicely. Look. Beautiful. Let's pop that back. And the one at the back is even bigger, actually. I'll leave that where it is, but you can see the blues coming through just here and there on the points. I'll try and get out of the light so there's no shadow. Yeah, it's a very big piece at the back there. Very quickly, I've spotted some orange calcite, the one we were just talking about, and that's again a slice. So it hasn't been polished, it's just been sliced right down the middle. And then you can see the raw rock on the back, the rock crystal as it would be, just coming straight out of the ground. Beautiful piece that. The energy field coming from that is strong. It's nice that it just stands there. Stand it close to your bed, stand it in your lounge, and just keep it in one place. That's what we suggest. The energy field grows stronger if it's just left in one place, a big piece like that. Orange calcite, it's such a great healer of the mind. Okay, here we go. Just doing a little bit of a pan round here. Oh, look at these raw quartz here. Can you see the colours coming through? Oh, that's a beauty there. It's nice to see the oranges and the tan colours coming through. Rutilated quartz there. Big piece. And then you can see some of the quartz is going quite pure there, almost transparent. Look at all the colorization there. I will try to just turn that around a little bit. Or if I walk around, that's it. Lovely pace, that. Rutilated quartz. Just as it would have been if you'd seen it in the ground and then grabbed it and pulled it out of the ground. Lovely. We have some nice, actually, just popped into my mind, some nice geode slices that are totally overlooked. And I'm going to show you those now because they're not very expensive. We managed to get them for a really good price, and the way they've been sliced, they make great bookends. Let me show you those right now. If I come down here, I don't need the fire one today. It's actually quite mild out, isn't it? Can you see these? Look at that. Let's get these. Oh, that's all right. You can see them there. Look at that. Lovely blue lace agate geodes there. They've just been sliced down the middle so that you can use them as bookmarks. Bookends, rather. You know what I mean. you couldn't use it as a bookmark. Well, you could, but it... It wouldn't work very well, would it? Look at the size of it. Heavy these are. What's nice about these, if I pick this one up, it'll give you an idea. You see how twinkly and sparkly it is there? Look at that. Thousands and thousands of little crystals right at the centre. Sliced down so you can see that beautiful, beautiful blue lace agate there. Look at the colours going through. It's a shame because a lot of people steer away from this type of crystal when it's like this, because in the 80s and 90s there was a trend of falsely colouring these, and now when you get a nice piece like this, people assume that the colours coming through are false, but this is all natural here. Nothing's been falsely dyed. This is how it looks in its natural form. I don't know why they falsely dyed crystals. They just seem to be a popular idea that colouring them really brightly would attract people, and it seemed to. People were buying them in the 70s and 80s like that, but we like them like this, don't we? We like them as they would have been coming out of the ground. Beautiful blue lace agate, very large, two pieces. They come as a set, and you don't have to use them as bookends. You can just literally put them together. Yeah, like that sort of thing. And you can see how they fit together. That looks like a heart. That's nice. Or maybe like a cat's head. Look. We've got a few of those in stock. As I said, we got them at a very good price. They've just been overlooked. Lovely, lovely. Blue lace agate. Okay. There we go there, black obsidian scrying mirrors for anyone that wants to increase their clairvoyance, to be used in the same way as a crystal ball. Oh, I know it's not a raw crystal, but let me show you this beauty. We did a crystal ball workshop just before the lockdown, actually, before we were told to all stay in our houses, and we got these beautiful giant crystal balls, and we sold them all, apart from this one that's left. It really is a giant, and it's Vogel quartz, so it's a proper crystal ball. And if I put my hand towards it, I won't be able to pick it up with one hand like this. If I put my hand towards it, you'll see how big it is. I class that as a large ball. And it's got a lovely Vogel quartz stand as well. Comes in a nice box to keep it nicely protected. It's quite a thing, that proper crystal ball. Very, very clear. A lot of our crystal balls in the past have been probably third generation, which basically means there's a very, very small amount of impurity in the crystal, just here and there. You wouldn't really notice it. But these ones that we've got here, I think they're first generation. There's no impurities in there at all, which is quite rare, really. We've been selling crystal balls for a long time. There's always a little bit or a little bubble or something in there. Those are really, really clear. Look at this petrified wood. Look at that. You can see it. It looks as though it would be a piece of wood, and essentially it is. But if you think about how this forms, look at the colours come through as well. Imagine the Jurassic period, the dinosaurs all roaming around. And imagine a piece of wood from a tree falls into a lake or a river, and because of the content, the rock content and the mineral content in the water, over time the wood, like a sponge, sucks in all those minerals and slowly turns into rock. So it displaces the wood, takes on the characteristics of the wood. In that case, you can see it's a piece of a tree there, and it just turns into rock, and then it's encapsulated for all time. A piece of rock instead of wood, petrified wood. That's where the term comes from, petrified meaning turning to stone. Look at that, you can actually see that stands up, that one does there. A piece of a tree that's fallen in a prehistoric Jurassic lake or river and then turned to stone by the minerals in the water. Very special. Let's put this by itself so you can see it. Take that off. Can see the grain, look, petrified wood. This is a showpiece. This is one of our favorite pieces. We've had that for a while. I think sometimes it's hard to appreciate what you're looking at if you don't know what you're looking at, when you realize just how old it is and that it is a piece of petrified wood from the time when the dinosaurs were roaming the earth. Maybe even before Cretaceous, Jurassic, that sort of time. Petrified wood, big piece, just as it would have been when the dinosaurs were roaming around. Incredible, really, isn't it? And then you have various variations of petrified wood. There's actually crystal growing through this piece. It's a lot lighter. It's still petrified wood. You can see the grain at the back, but I can also see crystal coming through. There's crystals forming in that one. So the wood basically took on the minerals of the water, turned into rock, and then at some point got pushed deep into the earth's crust and started to take on and form crystals with heat and with pressure. Okay. Lots of different types of petrified wood here. Beautiful pieces, beautiful. Actually, that piece there is a lovely piece of Merlinite. It does look like there's some wood going through it as well. But that's kind of what happens. This is what happens underground. You get crystals and minerals fusing together to sometimes create really strange effects. Merlinite is one of those stones that enhances your natural abilities. It's said to hold the knowledge of all who have worked with magic. It gives access to shamanic realms as well, supporting magical rituals. Look at that. It looks very magical. Merlinite spiritually helps you to travel into the past or the future to bring balance to the present. That's a special one, isn't it? An enhancer of your natural abilities, your natural spiritual abilities. And that's a large piece there, which looks like it has some petrified wood coming through as well, because you can see the wood grain. Of course, that's just my opinion. A sort of fusion between petrified wood and Merlinite is my best guess at that. Lovely, lovely. Well, we have gone around quite a few stones there, and there's so many. We'll do this one again, just focusing on the raw crystals. We'll do this one in more depth next time. Look at the size of that clear quartz. Yeah, you need two arms to pick that one up. We had three of these originally, all roughly about the same size and price, all around about the 500 mark. And we had them for quite a while. And this guy came in the one day and said, I love these, I'll have two. And you know how people just joke about things like that. And I just laughed at him and he says, no, I'll have two. That was a very good day. He pulled his car up and he was as happy as Larry. He had just the right place to put both of these, and he needed to, and it was just what he was looking for. If I take these necklaces off, you can get a better idea of the points of that. Lovely thick points there. Weighs a ton. You need both arms to pick that one up. It's nice to see all the colours coming through, and then the purer points as well. Look how white it goes towards the one side and also towards the top. Clear quartz, very high vibration, especially when it's big like this. Yeah, as I said, that guy had two. Oh, I'd have two, please. You don't very often get that happening. Great stuff. All right. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this little tour today of looking at the raw crystals and minerals that, well, some of them. We'll have to do further videos to cover all of them. It was a great thing to do. I love raw crystals. It's nice to see how they would have been when you pulled them straight out of the ground. Brilliant stuff. And just to hold that raw natural energy in your hands. It's magic, isn't it? Crystals are magic. Well, thank you for joining me today, and wherever you are and whatever you're doing, remain positive, remain calm, and I'll see you next time.
Monday, so good to